This video will introduce the text search query in a lot more detail. Let's start off by running a text search query by going to Explore and then choosing Text Search. We can use this query to find a word, phrase, a series of terms, or Boolean search across our files. As with the previous video, I'm going to search for the word fish. However, I also want to look for stems of this word, such as fisherman, fishing, and fished. To do this, I can use the Find option to scroll down to select stemmed words. By default, NVivo will search all files and externals. This time, I'm going to choose Selected Items, and then under Cases, I'm going to tick the People folder. This will tick all of our interview participants, survey respondents, and Twitter users. By searching in cases, I'm excluding the words of the interviewer, so none of the questions can lead the data here. I've also removed some of the other sources, such as the literature. Now that I'm happy with this query setup, I can click Run Query. The query is showing me that the word fish appears in 13 files with 139 references. I can click on References to order it by this, and it's showing me the Twitter dataset has this word and its stems the most frequent, followed by Robert, then Margaret. To explore these references in context, I can click on the References tab on the right hand side. This will show me the word fish and some broader context around it. The blue links at the top indicate which file it came from, so I can see this phrase here is in Thomas's interview, and these phrases here come from Dorothy's interview. As shown in the previous video, we can save the query criteria if we want to run this query again by clicking Save Criteria. Underneath the References tab, there will be further tabs depending on the source type that this term has occurred in. I can see for this search, we have text and database as options. If I click on text, it will show all of the text files that had this particular search term and its stems, and I can click through these sources to look at the context in which it occurs. Further down, I have dataset, and similarly can click between the datasets to see the results in that context. Finally, the last tab is that of the word tree, which shows a visualization of this query. If I use the option at the bottom, I can zoom out, and it will show the text term in the middle, and then all of the words that have appeared before it and after it. I can click on any of these tree branches to read through the whole line, taking me through what has been said. And if I want to look at the source that came from, I can hover over, and I can see this came from Robert. Alternatively, I could double click on it, and it will run a text search query, which will show me that particular result and give me a link through to the original source. Returning to my text search query, you'll notice the root term is fishing, whereas the term we searched for was fish. This is because we searched for stem words as well. And you'll see in the word tree ribbon at the top, we've got the option to switch the root term from fishing to any of the other terms it's found, such as fish, fished, and so on. If you like this visualization, you can right click and export that word tree, saving it as a JPEG, bitmap, or GIF file. The next video will continue looking at this particular search criteria and some of the further options in the text search query.